Hello, ladies and gents. I am Levi Peters, and this is Levi Explains on MIgardener. And today, we're talking about fruits and vegetables, or more specifically, which one is which. Now, we all know that this is a fruit, and that this is a fruit, and that this is a... What? A tomato's a fruit? Huh? No, you're tripping. No, but you probably have heard this before, that tomato's a fruit. And is it really? And yes, it actually is a fruit. And what if I told you that this is also fruit? And this, and this. Don't worry, I can explain this and it won't seem so weird after I do, hopefully. So what is a fruit? The definition of a fruit is a mature ovary that contains seeds. So after any flower, the seed-bearing capsule, the seed-bearing structure, is technically a fruit. So not just apples, oranges, and bananas and such have seeds. Also pumpkins, tomatoes, peppers, squash, zucchini, all that stuff. And including nuts too and legumes, so like walnuts and acorns and peas, those are all technically fruits, all of them. You're probably thinking, oh my gosh, man, so now what actually is a vegetable? What am I eating that's a real vegetable? Well, don't worry, there's a lot of vegetables. So what actually is a vegetable? Well, a vegetable is anything that we eat on the plant that isn't a seed or the seed capsule.
Like onions.
So if you eat the leaves, it's a vegetable. If you eat the roots, vegetable. Bulb, vegetable. Even the flower would be a vegetable. So lettuce, you're eating the leaves. You eat carrots, you're eating the taproot. You're eating onions, you're eating the bulb. So many herbs also fall into the category of vegetable, technically. So what does this mean for us? Does this mean that we have to call tomatoes and cucumbers and zucchini fruit?
No!
Of course not. I think this is where the confusion or the arguments actually lie. So though tomatoes are botanically fruits, scientifically fruits, technically fruits, they're vegetables socially. And that's what really matters in the end, because most of us grow these fruits and vegetables to eat for culinary use and not for botanical reasons. You don't see eggplants in the fruit section of a supermarket. You don't see tomatoes in fruit salads. I hope not. So that's what's important, and that's where it all lies, because we're doing this for more practical use. So we don't have to call tomatoes and cucumbers and zucchinis fruits, unless you're talking botanically. But if you're talking about everyday use and everyday life, they're vegetables. So yeah, that might take some of the confusion out the next time someone calls corn a fruit and you have no idea why. Now you know, and you don't have to feel so conflicted and confused. This one always confused me until I learned that, you know, scientific terms aren't always normal everyday terms and they can coexist with each other. So yeah, that's all I have for you guys today, and hope you liked it. I'll see you guys soon. Peace. A fruit salad with tomatoes in it.
Like onions.